Hi students, good morning. In the last class, we are discussed the problems related chord of contact and pole and polar of a circle. Okay. Now we are continuing in this session also some another problems related to these concepts. Okay. See the problem. If ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, is the polar of the point 1 comma 1 with respect to the circle x square plus y square minus 2x plus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0, and hcf of a comma b comma c is equal to 1, then find a square plus b square plus c square. I have to find the result of a square plus b square plus c square. Okay, so see the solution. So what is here given? Solution: given that the circle is taken, let s is equal to x square plus y square minus 2x plus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0. This is the given circle, and the line of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the polar of the point 1 comma 1. Is the with the polar of P of 1 comma 1. This line is the polar of the point 1 comma 1 with respect to the circle. With respect to the circle, S is equal to 0. Now we have to find A, B, C values. Then after we have to find A square plus B square plus C square. Okay. So this line is the polar of the point with respect to the circle. Now we are writing the equation of the polar of this point with respect to the circle using the formula S1 is equal to 0. Now we are writing the equation of the polar of P of 1 comma 1 with respect to S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. What is the polar equation we are writing for this circle? S1 is xx1 plus yy1, so minus g into x plus x1. Here f is 1, that is 1 into y plus y1 plus 1 is equal to 0. So we are writing the point 1 comma 1, we are writing s1. So we are substitute 1 comma 1, so x1 is 1, y1 is 1, then we are writing x1 is 1, y1 is 1, x plus x1 is 1, y plus y1 is 1 is equal to 0. Then we are getting x plus y minus x minus 1 plus y plus 1 is equal to 0. Here x will be cancelled. Then we are getting here y plus y, that is 2y. So minus 1 plus 1 is also cancelled, plus 1 is equal to 0. This is the polar of the point of P x1 y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. This is the polar equation. This is the polar equation, that is say equation 3. But given that equation 2 is the polar of the point with respect to the circle. So these 2 and 3 are on the same line. So these two equations represents the same line. Okay, since equation 2 and 3 are the same. Okay, now we are comparing like terms. What is the x coefficient here? There is no x coefficient. Therefore, a is equal to 0. What is here y coefficient of b? Here y coefficient is 2. B is equal to 2 and c is equal to constant here 1. Here the value is a is 0 and b is 2 and c is equal to 1. What is the here we have to find the HCF of a comma b comma c is equal to 1. Clearly the values of a is 0, b is 2 and c is equal to 1. So what is HCF of these values 0 comma 2 comma 1 is clearly 1. So therefore HCF of a comma b comma c is clearly 1. Okay, now we have to find the value. What is we have to find the value? A square plus b square plus c square. We want this value. So a square is a is 0, that is 0 square plus b is 2 square. What is c? C is 1 square. Okay, that is equal to 0 plus 4 plus 1, that is equal to 5. What is the value of a square plus b square plus c square? We are getting the value is 5. Okay, this is the next problem. Find the coordinates of the point of intersection of tangents at the points where the line x plus 4 by minus 14 is equal to 0 meets the circle x square plus y square minus 2x plus 3 by minus 5 is equal to 0. We have to find the coordinates of the point of intersection of the tangents where the line meets the circle. Okay, it is the our problem. See the solution. Okay, what is the given circle? That is given that the circle is x square plus y square minus 2x plus 3y minus 5 is equal to 0. This is the given circle and the given line is x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0. Minus 14 is equal to 0. Okay, now here this is the circle. Now the given line meets at the circle at capital A and capital B. Where the line meets the circle, draw the tangents at these points. Draw the tangents at these points. Now we have to find the point of intersection of these tangents. That is the say P. P is the point of intersection of the tangents where the given line meets the circle. Now we have to find the coordinates of the point P. Okay, by observing this AB is the chord of contact of P. Okay, and also P is the pole of this line with respect to the circle. What is the pole definition? If any secant meets the circle at capital A and capital B, then the point of intersection of the tangents at capital A and capital B is the pole. Okay, here the P is the pole of the line with respect to the circle. So by concept here our required point is nothing but the pole of the given line. So okay, by definition or by the concept, by definition P is the capital P is the pole of equation 2 with respect to the circle equation 1. Okay, so already we have to find the pole of the line with respect to the circle. Here we are giving not directly, so here the concept wise question here. So draw the okay, here given line meets the circle at capital A and capital B. Then we have to find the point of intersection of the tangents drawn at capital A and capital B. That is nothing but the required point is the pole of the line. Okay, Now, what is the pole of the line formula? P is equal to minus G plus L R square by L G plus M F minus N comma minus F plus M R square by L G plus M F minus N. We have in the previous class already done like this problem, where what is here, what is P? Here we have to find G value. What is G? Here 2G is equal to minus 2, then G is equal to minus 1, and here F is equal to 2F is equal to 3, F is equal to 3 by 2. Okay, so G is minus 1, F is 3 by 2. So what is the R? That is the radius. What is 1 square plus 3 by 2 whole square, 9 by 4, minus what is constant, minus 5, minus of minus plus 5. Okay, that is equal to root of LCM is 4. Here 9 plus 5 plus 1, 6, 6 fours, 24. That is equal to root of 33. Okay, 33 by 4. So the radius R is equal to root of 33 by 4. Okay, what is here L? L is equal to, what is the line x coefficient is 1, M is equal to 4, N is equal to minus 14. And also we have find LG plus MF minus N. We have to find this value. What is this value? Here L is, what is L? L is 1 into G, that is 1 into minus 1, minus 1. What is M? 4. 4 into, what is F? Now we are writing here, M is 4 and F is 3 by 2. What is minus N? Minus of minus plus 14. Here 2 times both, that is 14 plus 6, 20. Minus 1, that is 19. Okay, 2 into 3, 6, 6 plus 14, that is 20, minus 1, that is 19. Now we have to substitute these values in the formula. Here P is equal to, what is minus G minus 1, minus of minus plus 1 plus L. What is L? 1. What is R square? That is 33 by 4. By what is LG plus MF minus N, that is 19. And here what is F? F is equal to 3 by 2 minus F, that is minus 3 by 2 plus M R square. What is M? 4 R square. What is R square? 33 by 4 by, that is LG plus MF minus N, that is 19. Okay, then P here. So here 1 plus 33 by, so 4 19s, so that is 36, okay, 4 plus 3 7, okay, 76 comma, next minus 3 by 2, here 4 will be cancelled, that is 33 by 19. Okay, that is equal to here 76 plus 33 by 76. Here what is that is 2 19s, that is 18, 2 plus 1 38. Here minus 3 19s 56 plus here minus 57 66. Okay, that is equal to here 3 plus 6 9. Here 109 by 76. Here what is this is 3 plus 6 9, 9 by 38. These are the coordinates of the point P. P coordinates are, here we are getting 109 by 76 comma 9 by 38. These are the coordinates of the point P, where P is the point of intersection of the tangents drawn at the points where the given line meets the circle. That is our required point coordinates. We are getting the point coordinates are 109/76, 9/38. Okay. Next problem. If the polar of the points on the circle x square plus y square is equal to a square, with respect to the circle x square plus y square is equal to b square, touches the another circle x square plus y square is equal to c square, then prove that a comma b comma c are in geometrical progression, that is in GP. These a b c are in GP. Now I have to prove that. Okay, see the solution. First given first circle is given that the circle x square plus y square is equal to a square, that is the first circle. Look at this diagram. This is the first circle. Okay, and if the points on this circle, now the polars of the points on this circle with respect to the second circle touches the third circle. Okay, these three circles are concentric circles. This is the second circle and this is the third circle. These three are concentric circles. First, I have taken the point on the first circle, that is say P. Let P is x1, y1 be a point on this circle. Let P of x1, y1 be a point on the circle equation 1. Now, we are writing the polar of this point with respect to the second circle that touches the third circle. Given that polar of P with respect to the second circle touches the third circle, that is the given data. Now we have to prove that is A, B, C are in GP. That is our question. Okay. Now we are writing the polar of this point with respect to the second circle. Okay. Now what is the second circle here? X square plus y square is equal to b square. That is the second circle. And the third circle x square plus y square is equal to c square. That is a equation 3. Now we have to given the polar of P of x1, y1 with respect to the second circle. With respect to the second circle touches the third circle. Okay. Here the point is x1, y1 lies on the first circle. Since P is x1, y1 lies on 1. Therefore, x1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square. That is say equation 4. Okay. Now we are writing the polar of P of x1, y1 with respect to the second circle. Now we are writing the polar of P of x1, y1 with respect to the circle equation 2 is, what is the polar equation? S1 is equal to 0. What is S1 for the second circle? That is xx1 plus yy1 minus b square is equal to 0. That is say equation 5. So this is the equation 5. Is the polar of P with respect to the second circle is this is the line. So this line is touches the third circle. Now we have to prove that this line is touches the third circle. Okay. Now we have to prove that. Now we have to prove that the equation 5 touches the equation of the line 5 touches the circle equation 3. Sorry, this is given that, okay, so we have to given that we have given that the equation 5 touches the circle equation 3. We have given the polar of P with respect to the circle touches the third circle. So, if any line touches the circle, then what is the condition? R is equal to T. That is R3 is equal to T. What is R3? That is the radius of the third circle. So, this line touches the third circle. Okay. Then we have to condition is R is equal to T, that R is the third circle. So, we have to representing R3 is equal to T. What is D here? D is the perpendicular distance from the center of the third circle, that is 0, 0, third circle center is 0, 0, to the line, to the equation 5. Okay, that is the perpendicular distance from center to the third equation 5. That is the polar of P with respect to the second circle. Okay, what is R3? See that. What is R3? That is the radius of the third circle. That is R3 is C is equal to, what is perpendicular distance from origin 0, 0 to the line equation 5. This is the line equation 5. So, from origin to the straight line perpendicular distance is mod C by root of A square plus B square. What is here a constant? Minus B square. Modulus of minus B square by root of A square. What is A square? X coefficient, x1 square. What is B square? B is y1, that is y coefficient, y1 square. Okay, that is the perpendicular distance mod C by root of x coefficient square plus y coefficient square. So, from that cross quantifying this one. So, here C into root of x1 square, sorry. Now, in the place of writing here. Okay, what is x1 square plus y1 square? Here modulus of minus b square is b square. What is here x1 square plus y1 square from equation 4? From the point x1, y1 is lies on the equation 1. So, substitute in the x1, y1 in that equation, we are getting x1 square plus y1 square is a square. From equation 4, what is here x1 square plus y1 square? A square. That is b square by root of a square is a. From that, we are getting b square is equal to ac. Okay. Here b square is equal to ac. What is the condition? This condition is, so here a comma b comma c are in GP. If b square is equal to ac, then the values a comma b comma c are in GP. Okay, this is the our required result. Once again, I recall this one. So, here the polar of the point on the circle with respect to the second circle touches the third circle. That is our given data. Now, we have to prove that the values a, b, c are in GP. So, we have taken the point x1, y1 on the first circle, and these are the given two circles. Now, since here P x1, y1 lies on the first circle, now we are getting the result x1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square. Next, we have to write the polar of P of x1, y1 with respect to the second circle. With respect to the second circle, we are writing the polar of P with respect to the second circle. Then that is the equation 5. We are writing S1 is equal to 0 for the second circle. We are getting equation 5. That is the polar of P with respect to the second circle. Now we have to prove that this line is touches the third circle. We have given that equation 5 touches the circle equation 3. Okay, that is the, if any line touches the circle, then what is the condition? R is equal to D. For the third circle, we are writing R3 is equal to D. What is D? The perpendicular distance from center to the polar line. That is equation 5. Now we are calculating R3, that is the radius of the third circle is C. Here D is the perpendicular distance from origin to the line. That is mod C by root of A square plus B square. Here C is minus B square. So modulus of minus B square by root of A square is X coefficient square, B square is Y coefficient square, that is X1 square plus Y1 square. From equation 4, X1 square plus Y1 square is equal to A square. Now we have to substitute X1 square plus Y1 square is A square. Root of A square is A. From that, B square is equal to AC. So, therefore, A, B, C are in GP. This is the property for the, these values are in GP. Then, A, B, C are in GP. Okay. Okay, see the next problem. Tangents are drawn to the circle x square plus y square is equal to 16 from the point P of 3 comma 5. Find the area of the triangle formed by the tangents and the chord of contact of that given point P. That is our problem. See the solution. What is here given circle that is taken? Let S is equal to x square plus y square minus 16 is equal to 0. That is the given circle. And the given point P is 3 comma 5. Now we have to find the area of the triangle formed by the pair of tangents. Look at this diagram. This is the given circle and this is the given point P, that is 3 comma 5. These are the tangents from the P to the circle. They meet at capital A and capital B. Now the line joining AB. Now we have to find the area of the triangle PAB. Here AB is the chord of contact of P with respect to the circle. So already we have to discuss this theorem, area of the triangle formed by the pair of tangents and the chord of contact of the given point with respect to the circle is R into S11 whole power 3 by 2 by S11 plus R square. So this is the required area. This area is triangle PAB area. Now we have to find this area of the triangle PAB. Okay. Draw the tangents from P of 3 comma 5 to S is equal to 0. They meet at capital A comma capital B. Therefore, AB is the chord of contact of P of 3 comma 5 with respect to S is equal to 0. Now we have to find the area of the triangle PAB. We have to find the area of the triangle PAB. Okay. Now I have to find the area of the triangle PAB. Okay. So what is the formula? The area of triangle PAB. We know the formula, that is R into S11 whole power 3 by 2 by S11 plus R square. This is the formula for finding the area of the triangle formed by the pair of tangents and the chord of contact of P with respect to the circle. Okay. We already discussed this theorem. This is the formula for finding the area of the triangle formed by the pair of tangents and the chord of contact. Next, what is here R and S11? We have to find the radius. Where? What is the radius? R is equal to, here x square plus y square is equal to 16. That is r square is 16, that is r is equal to 4. And what is S11? What is S11? This is the length of the tangent. Okay, see the next problem. Find the locus of the point whose polars with respect to the circles x square plus y square minus 4x minus 4y minus 8 is equal to 0 and x square plus y square minus 2x plus 6y minus 2 is equal to 0 are mutually perpendicular. Now we have to find the locus of the point whose polars with respect to these two circles are perpendicular to each other. Okay, see the See the solution. Okay, given circles, given that x square plus y square minus 4x minus 4y minus 8 is equal to 0. This is the first circle. And the second circle, x square plus y square minus 2x plus 6y minus 2 is equal to 0. These are the given two circles. Okay. Now we have to find the locus of the point whose polars with respect to these two circles are perpendicular to each other. Look at the diagram. This is the circle. This is the first circle and this is another circle. Okay, these are the given two circles and we have to find the locus of the point. This is the say x1, y1. Now, the polars of the point P of x1, y1 with respect to these two circles are perpendicular to each other. So, draw the polar of P with respect to the first circle, this one. And draw the polar of P with respect to the second circle, that is say this the polar. These two polars are perpendicular to each other. That is given data. Now we have to find the locus of the point x1, y1. Now we have taken the locus of the point let P of x1 y1 be the locus of the point. Locus of the point. Now we are write the polars of this point with respect to the two circles. Now the polar of P of x1 y1 with respect to the circle equation 1 is same, that is S1 is equal to 0. Okay, now I am writing the polar equation for the first circle xx1 plus yy1 minus g, that is 2 into x plus x1 minus 2 into y plus y1 minus 8 is equal to 0. Now we are common the x. Okay, here x1, here minus 2 and also common y terms, y1, here minus 2. Okay, remaining terms are here minus 2x1, minus 2y1, minus 8 is equal to 0. This is the polar of P with respect to the first circle, that is equation 3. Now we are writing the slope of this polar. Okay, now we are writing the slope of this polar, the slope of equation 3 is same m1. What is the slope of this one? Minus x quotient by y quotient, minus x1 minus 2 by, that is y1 minus 2. Okay, next we are writing the polar of x1 y1 with respect to the second circle. Okay, now we are writing the polar of p of x1 y1 with respect to equation 2 is s1 is equal to 0. Okay, what is here? x1 plus y1 minus 1 into x plus x1 plus 3 into y plus y1 minus 2 is equal to 0. This is the polar of p of x1 y1 with respect to the second circle. Okay, now we are here also common x terms, here x1 minus 1 and also common y terms in y1 plus 3, remaining terms minus x1 plus 3y1 minus 2 is equal to 0. This is equation 4. Now we have to write the slope of this polar. Okay, now this is the equation 4. Now I am writing the slope of equation 4 is same m2. m2 is equal to, what is the slope? Minus x quotient by y quotient, minus of x1 minus 1 by y1 plus 3 minus x quotient by y quotient. So this is the slope of the polar of p with respect to the second circle. So here m1 is the slope of polar of p with respect to this first circle, and m2 be the slope of the polar of p with respect to the second circle. These polars are perpendicular to each other. Given that the polars are perpendicular to each other, therefore m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. These polars are perpendicular. What is the condition? Two lines are perpendicular, then m1 m2 is equal to minus 1. What is here m1? Minus of x1 minus 2 by y1 minus 2 into, what is m2? Minus of x1 minus 1 by y1 plus 3 is equal to minus 1. Here minus minus will be cancelled. We get x1 minus 2 into x1 minus 1, where cross multiplying this one, we get minus of y1 minus 2 into y1 plus 3. Now moving this side, we are getting x1 minus 1 into x1 minus 2 plus y1 minus 2 into y1 plus 3 is equal to 0. Now simplifying, then we are getting x1 square minus 3x1 minus x1 minus 3x1 plus 2. Here y1 square minus minus 2y1 plus 3y1 plus y1, here minus 6 is equal to 0. Now we are writing the locus of p of x1 y1 is, what is locus here? X square plus y square minus 3x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0. Here minus 6 plus 2, that is minus 4. So the locus of p with respect to these polars are perpendicular to each other. So that is the required locus is we are obtaining x square plus y square minus 3x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0. Okay.